With high diesel fuel prices and a desire to protect rivers and lakes from agricultural fertilizer and sediment runoff, farmers and landowners are looking for new ways to conserve soil and nutrients while reducing their fuel and related operating costs. Improvements in planter equipment and herbicides make no-till crop management a good choice in many fields throughout the state. Long-term no-till crop management effectively reduces soil erosion, restores soil structure, and improves water infiltration. But heavy Des Moines lobe soils, typical of north central Iowa and southern Minnesota farmland, tend to have poor internal drainage and can be slow to warm in spring. In those soils, no-till crop management is less successful. Strip-tillage crop management is a good alternative. A strip-till system offers a compromise between the benefits of traditional full-width tillage and no-till. Strip-tillage shouldn't be seen as a substitute for no-till on highly erodible land, where the tilled strips are subject to water erosion. This is especially true if the farmer strip-tills up and down field slopes rather than following a contour. Innovative, successful Iowa Learning Farms farmer partners like Tom Wagner of O'Brien County, Arlo Van Deest of Hamilton County, and father-son farming partners Gary and Dave Nelson of Webster County are all enjoying the benefits of strip-till crop management. Throughout this video, we will hear about the advantages that they have found in adapting their farms to strip-tillage. Soil conservation.
Conservation-wise, I think strip-till really works for us in this fairly level ground. Even on a sandy hill, we lose some erosion, but it's just in that 5-inch slot, and the other 30 inches is still sitting there.
For the biggest payback is the soil savings, you know, long-term, where we're keeping the soil in place a lot better.
Reduced fuel usage and labor requirements.
Finally, when diesel fuel went to $4, I go, I'm ready, and looked at it and gone into it full-time. We've completed our third year of everything strip-tilled.
We like the fuel savings. We like the time savings in the spring. Everything really fits well under our operation.
Improved fertilizer nutrient placement.
We'll put our fertilizer in the strip. We variable rate P, variable rate K, individually on our strip-till machine, and then we also apply anhydrous ammonia in that strip as well.
And improved soil structure and water infiltration.
In the olden days, fall plowing used to be such a nice seedbed and so soft, and every time you work it, it just goes downhill after that. So our seedbeds right now, we did them all last fall of our strips, and they're so mellow in the spring without touching them. I was at a seed and corn meeting this morning, and we're in a dry drought area here, and boy, they're really preaching on, you know, don't work your ground very much this spring, and I'm going, I'm not working mine at all. You know, I'm ready. Yeah, just pull out and plant. Before, we were full tillage with chop our corn stalks and run a V-ripper and then field cultivate twice. And field cultivating twice, you get it kind of lumpy and stuff, but this is so smooth.
Each of these farmers uses a slightly different approach to implement strip-till. You will see that strip-till management can be as simple as creating the tilled strips for seedbed preparation, or as detailed as merging seedbed preparation and fertilizer nutrient application into a single field operation. Strip tillage implements create a narrow, residue-free mounded strip, or berm, of soil about 6 inches wide, 4 to 8 inches deep, and 3 to 4 inches high on 30-inch crop row centers. The soil surface between tilled strips is left undisturbed, as in no-till, while the area where the crop is to be planted is tilled. Strip tillage is intended to create an environment favorable for rapid corn seed germination and seedling growth in early spring. The strip till operation can be completed after harvest in the fall or in early spring before planting. The tilled soil strips with less surface residue are dark, so excess moisture dries and the soil is quicker to warm for timely spring corn planting.
We've been able to, a lot of times people say, well, man, if it's wet in the spring, I'm not going to be able to get out there and plant. On some of those wet springs, we've actually been out there sooner than our neighbor because they're waiting to go out there and mud a field cultivator through to dry out that top 2 inches. Well, when you're drying out with a field cultivator, the top 2 inches, you may be drying out the top 2 inches, but you're creating that smear layer. With the soil structure that we've built, we're building a seed bed that's filtrating that water. We're driving on the old residue that's almost holding the tractor up in a sense.
Adoption of strip-till practices will require new equipment. Specific components of a strip-tillage implement vary. The basic configuration includes coulters, discs, a subsurface shank or mole knife to inject fertilizer at depth within the tilled strip, and covering discs. Farmers considering strip-tillage may opt to use strip-tillage for seedbed preparation only, or to simultaneously subsurface apply nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium fertilizers in the bottom of the tilled strip. Farmers considering strip-tillage should evaluate the costs and benefits to arrive at the solution that best fits their farming operation.
What we did was we took Iowa State custom rates, and we figured out what it costs us to put in our crop, and then we did it the way we used to do it, and we're saving like $26 an acre, and that's true figures. Everybody's costs are different because of their age of their machinery and stuff, so we just used custom rate guides and what we're saving. And time, that's like in the spring, the first spring we did it, there was two nights I came in for supper, my wife looked at me and goes, well, what are you doing here? And I go, there's nothing to do. The planter's full, and my son's running it, so I went home for supper, you know, where before you'd just work like crazy long hours to stay ahead of the planter with the field cultivator.
Some farmers that have adopted strip-till continue to broadcast apply their dry phosphorus and potassium fertilizer and follow up with the strip-till operation. This approach incorporates dry fertilizer into the tilled soil strips, where it is readily available to young crop seedlings. Many farmers apply anhydrous ammonia fertilizer as part of their fall strip-till operation. It's important to balance completion of strip-tillage following harvest with the need to delay fall application of anhydrous ammonia fertilizer until soil temperatures stabilize below 50 degrees Fahrenheit. As with any tillage operation, it's important to avoid field operation when soil conditions are too wet, as short-term soil clods and longer-term soil compaction can result. Ask a neighbor with strip-tillage experience to custom strip-till a portion of one of your fields to demonstrate how to set up and adjust the equipment before investing in your own.
Get with somebody that you like of their strip-till program that you've probably been watching for a couple years. Implement it on part of your field. Let your landowners kind of see what you're doing, because that's important, because they got to approve of what you're doing on their acres, because sometimes it may look a little bit trashier. It's going to look a little bit different than all the other fields in the area, but that trashy look, that's residue. That's organic matter. That's breaking down organic matter versus just burying it, making it black. I mean, so there's many benefits there.
Newcomers will quickly recognize the importance of proper equipment setup and monitoring, and must be willing to make adjustments based on soil and weather conditions. Strip tillage requires sufficient tractor horsepower to pull the equipment at optimum speed and operating depth for proper coulter and knife action, building the soil berm. Rule of thumb is to have a tractor with 20 to 25 horsepower per row of strip tillage. For example, you'll need a 250 to 275 horsepower tractor to effectively pull a 12-row strip tillage bar. This will allow you to operate the equipment at about 5 to 6 miles per hour and at proper depth. Operating the equipment at greater depth will require more tractor horsepower. For best results, invest in the most precise level of guidance accuracy you can afford. RTK guidance technology offers a sub-inch precision level of repeatable guidance accuracy, but requires a significant investment. It's important to plant the crop into the center of tilled strips. RTK guidance helps match up tillage and planting operations that may be separated by 6 months. Use of RTK guidance also reduces the need to match planter and strip tillage equipment width. An 8-row strip till bar with a lower cost and tractor horsepower requirement can confidently be matched with a 12, 16, or 24-row planter. For more information about strip-tillage crop management, contact the Iowa Learning Farms, your local Natural Resources Conservation Service office, or Midwest Land Grant University Extension Agronomy websites. Strip-tillage, when carefully considered and executed, can be a viable land management alternative that reduces soil erosion and production costs and will help you farm successfully.